Dear friends, today we are going to talk about P2 and P2 star timer in UDS. So the main factor is P2 and P2 star. P2 is nothing but minimum response time and P2 star is maximum response time, which means ECU will take some time to process the requested data from tester. Likewise, P2 star is maximum time. So minimum response time would be 50 milliseconds approximately, and P2 star maximum time would be 5 seconds, I would say in 5000 milliseconds. Here you can see the P2 server is 50 milliseconds. Normally this 50 milliseconds is configured in ARXML files. So when the tester send request, ECU process it and send back to the tester within 50 milliseconds. So here you can see the tester got a positive response. So let's see in next slide what will happen if it is exceed more than 50 milliseconds. When you send Dionysus session control, sub function is 01, then you will get positive response. Here I have mentioned X1 and X2 and Y1 Y2, which is nothing but P2 server and P2 star server, high byte and low byte. Here I can show you the one more example. So here tester requests the Dionysus session control, default session. So within 50 milliseconds, everything is processed perfectly. So tester got positive response. And in second example, you can see the tester request the same Dionysus session control default session, but the ECU couldn't process within 50 milliseconds. So the tester got NRC. Here you can see 7 of 1078. The 7 up is NRC ID and 10 is SID, and 78 is nothing but pending. If ECU is not able to process within P2 server, then it will send NRC 78. 78 is nothing but pending. So now what will happen? Again, ECU will try to process until P2 star time. It would be a 5000 milliseconds. Now we will see P2 star server. Normally P2 star server is configured as approximately 5000 milliseconds. P2 server is 50 milliseconds. It's configured in ARXML files. So when tester send request, ECU try to process it within P2 server. 50 millisecond, but here the ECU couldn't process it, so tester got NRC 78. Now the P2 server is extended to P2 star server, which means 5000 millisecond it's tried to process it, but here you can see within 5000 millisecond server couldn't process it, so tester got NRC 78. But somehow in third time tester got positive responses. So the maximum P2 star server time is 5000 milliseconds. So within 5 seconds, somehow the tester got first response. Now what will happen if it is extended more than 5 seconds? Let's see in next slide. Now here you can see the tester send request. The server try to process it within 50 milliseconds. Not possible. So tester got NRC 78. Again, the P2 timer is extended to P2 star server, 5000 milliseconds. So the ECU try to process it, but the iteration 1, iteration 2 and iteration 3, the server couldn't process it. Again, the tester got NRC 78. So now in the final time, the server time is extended to 5000 milliseconds. Now, suppose within 5000 milliseconds, if ECU is processed, then the tester will be get first response, or else then tester will be get NRC 10. Hope you understand P2 and P2 star timer. Thanks for watching.